Hey guys, so for today's video, I was inspired by AlishaMarie's floating bubble effect that she uses in her videos, as you can see here. So I wanted to show you how you can do that in iMovie. So first what you're going to do is to go to your footage. I just have mine in iMovie, and you want this footage to be your intro footage or somewhere where you're sitting down so that your face isn't going to move out of the bubble, if that makes sense. Next, I'm going to iMovie, I'm clicking design, and then I'm cropping that to 1280 by 720. That's the dimensions for YouTube. And then after that, I'm just clicking on the butterfly tool, which is overlays. I'm searching down to find the screenshot that I just took, and I'm dragging that in to fit the entire blank canvas. After that, I just combined that all, which is the little icon at the bottom. So here's where the part got a little tricky. I could not find a shortcut. I tried tons of different ways, but basically you need to get everywhere green except for your face or where you want to show in the bubble, if that makes sense. So what I did was I took a geometric circle, I made the center transparent just so that I had a little guideline, and I sized that around my face. And then using other geometric shapes, the same shade of green, I just went around and filled in the background space. Now I tried this using a shape cutout tool, but when I wanted to change it to a transparent canvas later, it did not work, so it'll make sense later. But just go ahead and fill your entire space with green. It kind of takes some time, but just go ahead and do that. When you wear red and the rope is long, and I'll guide you with the beating of my heart, and if the cavalry and the help don't come, well then we'll find a way to dodge a smoking gun. Now after I did that, I also decided to add a pink circle around it just so it's like a frame. So I just took another circle geometric overlay and I just made that middle transparent and changed the outside pink and just sized that to fit around my face. Well, you can't stop the tears from— So since you combined the picture at the very beginning, you're just going to want to go over to canvas on the left-hand side icon, and you're going to make that transparent so that background picture should go away, which will just leave you with the whole green sort of background and that frame that you made. So from here, you're just going to save it, so just click Save As and type in whatever you want and set that aside. Then you're gonna go back and delete the pink frame and just fill in the rest of the space where that old circle was with green, just so that you have the exact same color of green for a green background. I promise guys, this will all make sense in a second, but you just have to do those two main steps and then the rest is super easy. So now go into iMovie, and what you're going to do is drag in your footage of the intro that you want to be in the bubble, any parts of you talking or anything like that. Then you're going to drag in your circle overlay thing that you just made over top and leave that as a cutaway. Don't change that to green screen just yet. We will do that in a little bit. But yeah, you're just going to drag that over top and change that to fit. Make sure it's not on Ken Burns or it will start to make the bubble bigger, but just do that. So once you have all of that, you're going to export that into iMovie. I just did mine as one just because it's super easy, and I'm going to change that in a second. So after that, you're going to take your green screen background that you previously made in PicMonkey, you're going to drag that into iMovie and then drag your exported footage from the circle and the intro footage over top of that. And here is where you're going to make that circle little thing a picture in picture. I just sized mine to the bottom left corner, and then here I'm keyframing it. This is what makes it move throughout the video, so you can just click on that keyframing tool, push the space bar, kind of drag it around and let it play for a second, stop it, drag it around. If you guys want a video on how to keyframe, then let me know. I would be glad to do one. Once I'm done, here is what it will look like, kind of moving around in the green background. And now finally, once you get your keyframing the way you like, export all of that. I just did it as one once again and just replaced it because the old one doesn't matter anymore. So I'm just replacing that. So once that's exported, now I'm just taking the footage that I want the bubble overlay to be on top of, and I'm just dragging that into the part that I wanted. Then you're going to take your final exported project, put it on over top, and change that to a green screen. So here you should see it moving around your footage, and you can still hear the volume of you talking in the bubble. So I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you guys next video. Bye!